Joy has a superpower.
I am known as the nose. I have used my nose to smell diseases.
Joy can smell Parkinson's, tuberculosis, cancer, almost everything.
The week before lockdown started, I had COVID, and I could smell myself.
One day, we all could have this power. And to get us there, scientists are studying some of the best noses on Earth.
Your body constantly leaks biologically relevant information. This ability to diagnose by scent is something that we can achieve technologically.
And eventually build an electronic nose so small, it could fit in our phones.
We have these machines in our pockets. They have a mouth, they have an ear, and they have an eye already. What they need is a nose. Imagine the power of having 100 million diagnostic phones in 100 million pockets. If dogs can smell a disease earlier, faster, cheaper, and better than any clinical test that we have currently, we should be able to harness this technology and put it everywhere.
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
There is a, strangely enough, perhaps it's the heat. There is a smell from the lights.
Joy has had an incredible nose her entire life. It's called hyperosmia, the overwhelming sensitivity to smells. In fact, it runs in her family.
My grandmother taught me that people didn't understand it.
Joy's husband, Les, who had Parkinson's, helped her harness the power to diagnose disease.
She came home from work one day. I thought, gosh, that smell's got a lot worse. I used to describe it as quite a musky, greasy smell. So I did say to him, you've not showered. And of course he was quite annoyed because he had been showering and I had to let it go.
Even when Les was diagnosed, Joy didn't realize she was smelling Parkinson's. It wasn't until 30 years after she first noticed the smell, when they went to a Parkinson's support meeting, that she understood her superpower.
I realized that other people with Parkinson's smelt exactly the same as him. It wasn't until years later that I began to realize throughout my nursing, I had used my gift to help people.
The realization inspired Joy to put her nose to work, to determine the exact smell of Parkinson's, travel to Africa to smell tuberculosis, which she says smells like brine, and go to California to study cancer's earthy smell.
Imagine being able to do that without having to go to Joy, and imagine being able to do that for many different conditions.
But there's a problem. Replicating olfaction has proven to be difficult. Smell is complicated.
The problem isn't so much in the detection. The problem is in making sense of it.
We generally understand how our noses function. Take a sniff, odors enter our nose, receptors interact with those molecules, then a signal is sent to the brain. But what we don't know is how we make sense of the complex chemical composition of every smell, something that Joy and dogs are particularly good at.
What they're seeing is the footprints that a disease such as cancer leaves on your body odor, no matter where the emanations are. This is quite remarkable. No analytical tool can do it. Nothing has beat the dog yet at the understanding part, because in the real world, we have a literally unlimited number of new scents being produced every day.
But Andreas's breakthrough came when he realized we don't need to understand exactly how our noses work to be able to replicate the ability electronically.
What we're trying to develop here is artificial dog intelligence. This is the evolution of the Nano-Nose. This piece of plastic with horrible epoxy around it. This is very large, very heavy. I had this brilliant idea to have three nostrils instead of two. It ended up not working. In the end, we ended up with this. It's a very simple design. It fits in your smartphone this year. Currently, what the technology is, it is sort of half biological, half electronic. So it's a bit of a cyborg situation.
Andreas's design sort of works like a nose. It consists of synthetic protein receptors grown from the same ones in our noses. An electric current amplitude moves up and down depending on the receptor's response to that scent. Then it's analyzed by artificial intelligence.
To have this superpower in your pocket is possible. The technology is available. It's all about integration.
A handful of researchers are pursuing the same goal with different applications. Noses that can detect cable fires, spoiled food, or explosives. But soon, a super-smelling smartphone could save our lives.
Scent data from each person would be transformative for society. Currently, we're experiencing three pandemics. One is COVID, one is cancer, and one is mental health. Those three things can be diagnosed by dogs, and that ability can be now transferred to wearable or phone-like devices.
Les died when he was 65. As a doctor, he realized what it meant. So he started thinking about his earlier signs and symptoms before he was diagnosed. We spent quite a few days every week writing them down. He was totally animated by it. I could see the old Les again.
Does it feel like you have a superpower?
Well, a few people have said that. I call it a gift. It is smell in my life that makes me quite happy, really.
I want my kids to grow up in a world where they don't have to be felled by completely avoidable dangers. The fact that we're carrying all this fantastical technology and it's under-leveraged, this thing needs to do more for us than just sell us ads. It needs to protect our health, and it can.